This is a big deal. So Qualcomm just announced their brand new Snapdragon X2 Elite Extreme. What this is going to bring to the PC should be a huge, huge step forward. So first and foremost, I do want to give a huge thank you to Qualcomm for inviting me out to my third Snapdragon Summit. It's been really interesting to see the evolution of things because the first time it came was when they announced X Elite. So there are two big announcements here at Snapdragon Summit this year. First of which is on the PC side, where they have the brand new Snapdragon X2 Elite, as well as the Snapdragon X2 Elite Extreme. And on the Android side, you get yourself the brand new Snapdragon 8 Gen 5. But across the board, you're seeing a big jump to CPU performance. So both of these are using Qualcomm's new Orion 3rd generation CPU core. Now, as of recording this video, all I've been able to do is take a look at the demo models and some of the benchmarks that Qualcomm have provided. So all of these were done on reference devices, but what they're quoting here is pretty impressive specs. 39% more single-threaded performance on the Snapdragon X Elite Extreme, as well as up to 50% more multi-core performance. Now, a big part of that is because this new chip is up to 18 CPU cores. It also can boost two of those cores to 5 gigahertz, which is incredibly fast. Snapdragon, since they've really relaunched on Windows with Snapdragon X Elite last year, it's made some huge strides. One of the big ones is in app compatibility. So when X Elite first shipped, there was reasonable support. There's also a Prism emulator built into Windows, so if there is an older app or something that hasn't been optimized, it should theoretically run pretty much seamlessly in the background. But there were still some holdouts. One of the big ones was on the gaming side. The fact that you can run Fortnite on Snapdragon X series, and that's just not the brand new X2 Elite or whatnot. You actually can play Fortnite on a Snapdragon device right now, thanks to the fact that Epic and Qualcomm have collaborated to help fix anti-cheat. So in the past, because anti-cheat wasn't supported, it would completely shut the game down. It wouldn't even begin to launch. But now that that is supported, theoretically, you can play it. And I was able to play Fortnite on the brand new Snapdragon X2 Elite Extreme, so the full 18-core configuration with the big GPU, all the memory, and it was a really good experience. Now, I want to be clear, you're not buying a Snapdragon laptop to be a gaming PC. It can do some gaming, but it is a big step forward because, look, most people don't buy a laptop just to spend all day in Word or in a browser or whatever the case is, even if you're a video editor or a gamer. Like, everyone needs their devices to do multiple things. And so it's really important for the Snapdragon team to actually make sure these devices have the capability of doing pretty much anything that someone throws at it. More and more of these specialized apps have been updated and optimized. This morning, Adobe were talking about how their entire suite, especially on the video editing side, is now fully supported on Snapdragon X series chips. And in the brand new Snapdragon X2 Elite, the NPU has seen a major overhaul. So it's gone from 45 TOPS all the way up to 80 TOPS, which would mean that not only can you run bigger models, especially because a lot of these laptops will likely be shipping with some pretty solid amounts of RAM, but importantly, you'll be able to run them much faster. One of my favorite demos, though, was Voice Mod. This is leveraging the NPU and the silicon, and what it allows you to do is in real time, change your voice entirely. And the results were, shall we say, disturbing.
Is everyone ringling the dingling yet? You know, I just think that the more time I spend with this, I just feel like it's a little weird, you know? I mean, just like, is this really what we want to use for AI? Maybe it is. Maybe all of my videos should be shot like this.
One of the coolest demos I got was something that I was not expecting to actually care about, which is Snapdragon Guardian. So the idea here is incredibly cool. So for certain Snapdragon X2 Elite systems, so it certainly won't be on all of them, unfortunately, but certain devices will have an additional little modem. So this modem is not actually meant for you as the end user to use it for like 4G and 5G and stuff. Instead, it is a tiny modem and a tiny battery, and that is connected directly to the chip. And that has some major advantages because first and foremost, if you're like an enterprise sort of organization, you can geofence devices. So like, hey, if someone takes their laptop home and it gets lost or stolen, you can keep it from operating outside a certain spot. You can remotely kill it, even if it's in airplane mode. And the cool thing is, this all works even if the laptop is off. So imagine someone steals your laptop, they immediately turn it off and they start making a run for it. Even with the laptop being off, that little battery is still enabled in that little modem. And so if you go on to the Snapdragon Guardian app or site or wherever the sort of the backend is, you can remotely disable that device. You can remotely wipe it, even if it's off. Qualcomm have made a number of reference devices. So there are a few here. So there is one ultra-thin tablet, which is much more something like a Surface, perhaps. There's also a thin and light laptop, They also have this bigger 16-inch reference device, which supports a thermal envelope of up to 120 watts, and this is what all the benchmarks are run on. And then one of my favorite things is they have these tiny little mini PCs. So this is a little round one, which I'm not gonna lie, when I first saw it, I absolutely thought it was a wireless charger, but no, this is a full 18-core chip inside this mini PC. And the best part is, it is entirely fanless. Instead, it is using the Frore air jet cooling, which is a really cool piece of technology, by the way, where essentially, instead of using an actual fan to spin, it uses a membrane to vibrate really quickly to essentially push the air through. Now, this is some tech that's been rolling out over the last couple of years, and it's a little difficult to fit in laptops because it's bigger, it's more expensive, and it also takes up more power than a fan. But you think about something like a mini desktop, you're plugged in, you don't care about a tiny extra little bit of power when it gives you a much more silent operation. And honestly, the tech is incredibly cool. I'm not gonna spend a ton of time talking about mobile, but Snapdragon 8 Gen 5 is a pretty big step forward. It is using the same third generation Orion cores, which means you're getting get a big jump to CPU performance. You got a lot more GPU performance as well. And as you would expect, this chip is going to be in a whole bunch of devices coming soon. So again, this is Snapdragon Summit. This is where they kind of announce the chips. The devices typically come a little bit later, but I'm sure you can imagine that all the usual suspects will likely be upgrading to Snapdragon 8 Gen 5 in the not too distant future. Now, something else I thought was really interesting that Cristiano, the CEO of Qualcomm, mentioned in his keynote was that 6G is coming. Now, I think like a lot of you, I think that 5G has been here for like 5 minutes and like, what are you talking about 6G? But according to Qualcomm, they're actually well on target to bringing out 6G in the not too distant future. So you're gonna have some early devices in 2028. Now that's not necessarily going to be likely something that you and I could buy, but 6G is coming. I'm incredibly happy that Qualcomm have dove so heavily into the Windows space. For so long, there was nothing exciting going on. Like we were seeing 3% upgrades, 5% upgrades. But now that we have Snapdragon pushing so hard, everyone is moving forward now. And when you look at the kind of gains that these chips are seeing just over the last generation, it's really impressive stuff. Now, just anecdotally, I have not been able to spend time with any retail units, so we'll likely be seeing actual Snapdragon X2 Elite silicon in real hardware probably next year. So I'm sure there'll be a variety of devices. But just from the experience that I've had over the last year, year and a half of using Snapdragon, it's good. So I know that a lot of people have been concerned about compatibility, and that's fair because especially at the very beginning, there were some apps that just simply were not natively supported on Snapdragon. However, at this point, something like 90% of the average use of people actually using Snapdragon on Windows is of natively compiled apps. I can say for myself, that's been very, very true. I mean, a lot of the apps I use on an everyday basis are absolutely optimized, no problem. So I've been using a couple of devices. I use the Lenovo Yoga Slim 7X for a while. I love that laptop. Actually, lately, I've been using the Surface Pro 12-inch, mostly because it's incredibly tiny. Now, that actually uses the X Plus, which is the sort of little brother to the X Elite, and certainly a lot smaller than something like the X2 Elite. But what I find is that what you get with the battery life, it's actually really good. For me, it kind of changes the way that I think about using a Windows device, because there's no fan, and that is something that you can do. Again, I was able to see with an X2 Elite, they had a little fanless sort of tablet setup. So you can certainly run these at very low TDPs and have it be fanless, no problem. But it's beyond that, right? It's the battery life of knowing that I can go out, like I've been walking around all day, shooting stuff here, taking notes and keynotes, and guess what? I have not needed to bring my charger at all because I know that I'm gonna get my solid 7-8 hours of battery life without a question. And that paired with the level of performance that you're getting with X2 Elite as well as the X2 Elite Extreme, it's really exciting because I think what they've done here is they've iterated on what was already, in my opinion, a quite good product and given it a ton more performance. I mean, 39% more single core, 50% more multi-core. I mean, this is not just stuff that, oh, you're gonna load Google Chrome faster or something. I mean, you can actually run real pro apps on these chips. And as a creator, that's really exciting. So that, my friends, is a look at what has been announced here at Snapdragon Summit 2025. I'm curious, what do you think? Because to me, the big announcements of Snapdragon X2 Elite as well as X2 Elite Extreme mean that you're going to get still the efficiency and all the fun stuff that you come to expect with Snapdragon Silicon, but also a ton of performance. Thank you very much for watching. Make sure to subscribe to the channel and ring-a-ling that ding-a-ling button. And of course, huge thank you to Qualcomm for sponsoring my trip out here to Snapdragon Summit. Excuse me, my friends. See if I can get my hands on one of the Snapdragon X2 Elite Extreme chips. Actually, I have the chip. I just have like anything to put it in.